Hey friends, welcome back. Today I'm going to give you something very interesting. What is it all about is ambient intelligence. What is called ambient intelligence? We are going to have a quick note on that, and not more than 5 to 7 minutes is what I require from you. I hope you will definitely like it at the end of the session. Ambient intelligence, we are going to understand that. What is it? Let's define it first. In the computing, ambient intelligence is referred as something that gets you more responsive, sensitive support to the people who are using technologies. That's how I can conclude it easily. I can say that it's all about the electronic environments that are sensitive and responsive to the presence of people. I'm going to support you through technologies for whatever you are going to do. It's going to give you all sort of support, and they are going to be real-time and reactive. It is actually emerging that brings intelligence to the environment. We are going to get intelligence added to the environment that we are living and make those environments really usable, really friendly for us. For example, I'm sitting in a room. If you add intelligence to this room through adaptive lighting, through adaptive AC or something like that, it can be called as ambient intelligence. I'm going to get more intelligence to the environment, and I call it ambient intelligence. Ambient intelligence research actually uses multiple technologies together. It's like a coagulation of multiple technologies that come together. It uses sensor networks, IoT, pervasive computing, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, and many technologies come together to make sure that all the advanced technologies are used to get you real good ambient intelligence around you. So people call it ambient intelligence, and it is going to get you a nice ambience around you. Now, what are the characteristics that the ambient intelligence systems will have? I have made a very quick note here. The first one is going to be all about it being embedded and ubiquitous. Naturally, when you think about it being embedded, it being technologies which are connected together, we'll have a lot of equipment, lot of devices connected together, and it has to be ubiquitous. It can be accessed from anywhere, it can be controlled from anywhere. You gain a lot of control to it, and it's going to be really intelligent. And the second point that we need to understand is it is all intelligent and context aware. Right, intelligent in the sense it should understand the data, it should understand your input, and it should also be context aware. A simple example I can give you: when you are driving your vehicle in a highway, it should provide you inputs for driving on the highway driving scenario. If you are driving it in the city mode where there will be a lot of traffic, your ambient intelligence systems will provide you support and information that you need for driving in the city mode. Very simple. I am sitting in a room during the daytime, so I may need a little bit of lighting only. But when I sit in the room during the nighttime, I may need more light. When I'm working, I need more light. So that all can be made context aware, and that should also understand that what are we working on. It should understand what we need. So that context should be very clearly made aware to the systems and all the ambient intelligence systems also. And then the next point is very important: personalized. Your Google Assistant is personalized to you. My Google Assistant is personalized to me. And the updates and the suggestions that come from the ambient intelligence systems are really personalized. And if I like cricketing related details, I'll get only the cricketing updates. If you like medicine related details, you'll get only medicine details, and it's going to be highly personalized. And the next point that we need to understand is they are adaptive, they are real time, and they are reactive and responsive. They have to be real time. In the sense, when you need a service, it has to happen immediately without having any delay. A logical correctness of the operation within deterministic deadline is called real time. And ambient intelligence systems must give me real time and reactive responses. And finally, it has to be anticipatory. It should even anticipate what you want, and it should provide you support. These are all some of the simple characteristics that one can really talk about when you are asked about what are all the characteristics of ambient intelligence systems. And what are the technologies that are connected to ambient intelligence systems? I'm just quoting a few here. We have a lot more. The first one that we need to understand is artificial intelligence. We have got machine learning, deep learning, and lot more content from the artificial intelligence sector like NLP. They are all connected pretty closely with AMI. And pervasive computing, without networking and IoT, nothing happens. And sensors, they are like kidney, heart, liver of entire system. Without sensors, things doesn't work. AR, VR, and HCA, human-computer interaction, the augmented reality, the virtual reality, all these technology stacks come together to get you a very beautiful system called as, very beautiful setup called as ambient intelligence setup. And these all work together to get you a nice, really nice and really cool stuff. And where all we can, what all can be the ambient intelligent environments? Where all we can go with ambient intelligence setup? It's all very easy to understand. Transportation and vehicle. We add intelligence to the vehicle, we add more intelligence to the environment that we are driving with the vehicle, and that's called transportation intelligence. Agriculture and intelligence in the farming, intelligence in the agro services, we can add ambient intelligence to it. Industry, intelligent machine tracking, intelligent monitoring, all those things can be also called. and smart education, intelligence in education can be given. When you are sitting in a room, if I get you augmented reality and virtual reality kind of interaction for teaching, that is called ambient intelligence, very simple. And smart home, intelligence in home, that I talked about a little bit in the previous couple of slides. When I have intelligence in the home, if I want to switch on TV and if I want to see one particular channel every day, it happens at the same time, the channel should automatically be on. The sound that I'm very much interested in, the amount of audio feed that I'm interested in, the color of the light, the setup of the light, the all these things can be made little more intelligent, and that's called smart home and intelligence in home. This is an emerging area, and I hope I have given you a glimpse of it, and if you want more details about it, you should probably go through it with more resources. If you have any questions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be able to take it up. And thank you very much for following my channel and the content. If you have any questions, suggestions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. Thank you.